Hi there, this is Ash and a warm welcome to my latest model train review video, of which this one is the final model train review video to come of January 2020. And I want to save this one till last of this month, as this is my HST that I now have, and I do have a full rake of 9 coaches to go with this train as well. This one is a limited edition of 1,000 train packs produced worldwide, and this one is the GWR Class 43 HST pack from Hornby. And if this is the correct version, I believe there is some etched metal GWR logos that can be attached to the side of the power cars if desired. And just lifting up the box, here is the reference number, which is on the base of this one. The reference number is R3510 GWR, just to correct myself there. HST power car, this one is numbered as 43187, which will be the powered unit, and 43188, that will be the unpowered unit. Just to turn the box around, and here are the power cars like so, and here is the details about the Class 43 HST. So if you want to pause the video just to read all of this, I'm just making sure that the camera is picking up all the text, but if you want to read this in your own time, please feel free to pause the video, as you're most welcome to do so. And to be truthful, I got this one for Christmas 2019 and I haven't tested it and I've not used it at all, just trying to get the flap to release. There we go, was a wee bit stubborn there. But just to unpack this on camera, although I will be doing a 360 degree rotation anyways, the box is quite weighty naturally, as the power unit of this HST does have all-wheel drive. And just to give you a wee sneak preview there, there is some information in there. But what I'm going to do, just until I get these tapes cut, as I don't really show tools in my videos, I'm going to pause the video momentarily whilst I remove the lid, and then we can have a look at the contents of this box. Right then, now that I have removed the bottom tape, as I just peeled it off, here is what we have inside the box. This one does come with a limited edition certificate, so this is all new to me, as I think the other HST that I have covered, which was back in early 2017, or it could have been 2016, I can't remember which, was the Virgin Trains NRM HST pack. Anyways, this one is numbered as 0108 in the bottom left there, and that is the certificate of authenticity. Naturally, we do have a set of instructions, of which these are just common instructions for maintenance and DCC fitting, etc. Like so. If you want to add sound to this model, you can do so as well, of which we'll show you there likewise. And one of my plans is, with this HST, I do plan to add DCC sound into these models, as I think it would make these HST sound grand. And we do have some more packaging, so before we move on to that, let's just have a wee look at the accessories. These are just cosmetic Buckeye couplers, like so. Now I have them in front of the camera, as I'm not filming from behind the camera. And I do believe I'm going to get a hold of them. And here is your etched set of GWR nameplates, of which I believe you do get a pack of two, which will probably do both power cars. And that moves us on to the fun part, of which in this part of the video, I'm going to start off with the unpowered car first, as this one it's going to be a wee bit tricky getting this out, but there is no tissue wrap, which can either be a good thing or a bad thing. And this one is the unpowered unit, numbered as 43188. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to place it on the track, but we will have a 360 degree rotation of that very soon. And I'm going to put these accessories away, as I don't think I'm going to be using them, although I will be fitting the GWR nameplates later on, which means there's only one thing left to do, and that's to unpack the power car. So definitely a good point about the new style Hornby packaging. It does make removing the trains easier, although I believe the tissue wrap did stop them from rubbing against the polystyrene, so it will be interesting to see in a few years how this newer packaging will cope. But this one is numbered as 43187, and this one does have the motor unit, and we will cover some of the details once we get it on the turntable. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pause the video momentarily whilst I get rid of this packaging and stuff, and then we can have a look at the train in our next step of this review, which will be the 360 degree rotation. I will be back in a moment. Now we have the model on the turntable, we'll first of all start off with the model of 43187. That is the powered unit on this train park. As I do have the Mark 3s on the test track ready to go, although I did have to plan well ahead to get the full set, so I'm now happy. And it will make the test run more interesting and enjoyable, or at least that is the intent anyways. And another thing to mention about this train park, the paintwork is of a gloss finish, of which is something different, as the gloss finish is not something I have on many of my model trains at all, as most of my model trains are a satin or a matte finished if they are not weathered. And let's start off with the cab then, shall we? As I'm going to do some close-ups of this. The front end is based on the post 2007 refurbishment, as you have the 2x2 clusters instead of the usual forehead and two taillights like on the old original setup. The handrails and the window wipers, they are separately fitted, and the doors do open on these models, although I will not be demonstrating this on mine, for the reasons being is that this feature is just not something I really use, and the cab door is flush closed against the body shell, and I don't want to distort anything. The model does have quite a lot of extensive separately fitted detail parts, especially around where the compressor is. And I'll just zoom in on that now, which is just behind the front wheel set. And you can just see that the ventilated brake discs are nicely modelled on this train as well, which is not regularly covered on other models of this scale. Considering this is 00 gauge, it is a very nice touch indeed. And this is probably one of Hornby's best modern diesel passenger trains, or at least that is in my opinion. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to raise the camera a wee bit, as this tripod is a little bit low. So just going to adjust that camera, as then we can have a better view of the roof. Just having a look at the exhaust and the exhaust smoke deflector shield, which is just in front of the outlets, of which is just behind this plate. This of course was modified when these HSTs were repowered with the MTU, I think it was a V4000 unit or something like that. There is exquisite detail on the top of the roof as well, and this one does have the single fan, which I think was identical to the Virgin Trains one that I covered many years ago. So just look at that beautiful detail. And what I'm going to do, just to show something off here, just going to rotate the train to exactly side on, as these grills here where the radiators are, this is see-through on the non-powered unit. Although there is a valid reason why you may not see through to the other side on this model, is this one has a very heavy metal chassis which spans the whole of the engine room area up to the luggage van door, as this model does have all-wheel drive and a 5-pole central can motor. So just wanted to mention that to you. So what I'm going to do, just to give you a better close-up of the fan on the top, I'm going to just make some more adjustments to my tripod. As I'm not sure if the camera is picking this up, but there is a fan underneath the roof grills, although it does not rotate, so it has been disconnected or decommissioned from the driveline, as the motor wasn't powerful enough to power the fan, and it often did result in the motors on some of the older Hornby HSTs burning out. But that is the reasons behind why they have been disconnected on the newer models. But anyways, let's just zoom out, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the train back into its original position and lock the camera approximately, and just starting from the front and near side, we shall now commence with a 360 degree rotation. Just making sure not to crop any of this fantastic model, as I'm not completely behind the camera, so it is quite difficult to judge. But I'm making adjustments to make sure that everything is in the filming zone. What I'm going to do, just to avoid repeating myself too much with the unpowered unit, I will just show you the see-through grills only on the unpowered power car, as then I can then move on to the fun part of this review, which will be the test run. And I really am looking forward to doing this test run, as this one is the only Hornby HST of the premium model that I have at present, although I'm planning to get some other GWR train parks if I can, as well as other liveries that are modern and up to date. And correct me if I'm wrong here, I believe that GWR or Great Western Railway withdrew their long haul HSTs back in June 2019, if I have this date correct. Although I do believe GWR are keeping a few HSTs as the HST Minis or the HST Castle class, which have displaced some class 158s as these have the newer sliding door mark free carriages. But any information would be appreciated on when the long haul GWR HSTs last ran, as I may do a special dedication video in model form, of course, as I do really like the HSTs, and once I get enough of them I will do a special HST model train running session video amongst others. Anyways, that's the 360 degree rotation covered on the power unit, so it will be time to move over to the unpowered unit momentarily, just to show you the see-through grills, and then we will move on to and commence with a test run. This one is 43188, and this is just showing the unpowered unit momentarily, as apart from the lack of a motor, the detail and everything else is very much identical to the powered unit. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to show the see-through grills, and you can just see it there. I'm going to adjust the camera just so we get a dead-on side view of the radiator grill, and as I did mention earlier in this review, you can see through the other side, just like you can on the Hornby Class 60 and some of the other premium diesel model trains that Hornby have produced in the past. So I just wanted to show that, as it does show how much dedication and attention to detail that Hornby put into their top of the range models, really. And that is what I really do like about the premium Hornby HST. But anyways, just to prove a point, this one is 43188, and it's now time to move on to the most fun part of this review, and that is the test run. Now it's time to commence with the fun part of this review video, and this is the test run. I'm using the Kato controller, as I have done in the majority of my reviews, and let's apply some power to the track. And you will see straight away that the model does have working head and tail lights and cab lights. So I'm going to do, just going to take this power up to exactly 50%, as this one being a brand new model train, I don't want to put too much strain on the motor, but just look at how smooth that train runs, and that is just 50% power. I'm just using a Hornby DB Schenker Class 60 as a background train with just six of my premium tankers, and I'm using the full 9 cars, which will match this HST nicely, as I've always wanted one of these. And a full 9 car HST does look very impressive. I believe the Great Western region did have some 9 car HSTs, although most of them were in the 2x8 formation, with some being in the 2x7 formation, if I have this correct, as the 9-car HSTs would have been used on the heavier, more congested passenger routes. As I believe the 9-car HSTs would have been used from London Paddington to places like Penzance, for example. And even more so during the holiday season. Considering this is a brand new train that's never been run before. And another plus for this new packaging is that there is no transit bracket to remove either, which was the case on the other older HST models. So Hornby have definitely improved their packaging over the recent years. What I'm just going to do, just going to zoom out a wee bit just to get more of the train into view, and I may turn it down a notch. So just back that down to about 40%, as then we can have a nice smooth pass. And then what I'm going to do, I will allow a few more passes, and then I will adjust the camera just to show off the tail lights on the unpowered unit. As both models are more or less identical, apart from one being powered and the other one just being a non-powered unit, of course, but I just wanted to make an extra effort with the background train being a bit better quality as well. As this one is my favourite model train, and I will be using this new HST in many model train running sessions to come throughout 2020 and beyond. And as you can probably tell, I'm a big fan of the Great Western Railway theme, so I was determined to get one of these GWR HSTs at some point anyways, and I'm very pleased that I managed to get hold of one, along with 9 matching Mark III carriages as well. The one thing I will say is that these Hornby Premium HSTs are very strong and powerful pullers, as the Lemur and the older Hornby HSTs probably would struggle to haul a train of this size. But this one hasn't skipped a beat at all. It's a very smooth runner. Although these train parts are very much over the £250 mark, which depends on the livery and if the model is a limited edition or not, I do think the price is worth paying for. Or you could always wait for a special sale to come on. if you wanted one of these train parks. As I think this one was released as a limited edition in 2017. Although, to be truthful, and if I have my calculations correct, there are at least three other GWR train packs now available, if I am to include the 2020 release. As there is the one with 43093, that is numbered, named as Old Oak Common. And there is the one with the Meningitis Trust named HST Power Car as well. As these two that come in the first issue are not named at all. Which is grand, as to be honest, I do like to have some unnamed model trains. But anyways, I'm going to allow one more pass and then we will switch the camera to another view so that we can see the tail lights a bit more. I'm hoping that this view will show the tail lights from the trailer end, that is the non-powered power car, like so. In my opinion, the head and tail lights on both of these models isn't too bright, and it's not too dull either. The ambience of the directional head and tail lights is about right, as where on some other models the headlights can be a bit too powerful to be realistic. What I'm going to do is going to turn up this power a wee bit, as I think there is a dead section of track where the background train is running along, as there is a slight hill that the Class 60 has to pull these wagons up anyways, which is why it loses speed, as this floor is not even. But my model trains tend to cope okay, mostly anyways. And to be honest, I've not had too many derailments on this twin oval of track. What I shall be doing very soon is I will be wrapping up this part of the video with my final score and verdict. I will conclude this review of the Hornby GWR HST twin power car park, of which the reference number is R3510, with my final score and verdict. As I'm sure that most of you may agree with me, this is probably one of the best replicas of the Class 43 HST that is available in any scale. And this is certainly the best 00 gauge model that is available on the model train market. And if you are interested in the HSTs, I would definitely recommend getting this model, because not only does it look good, or should I say fantastic, which is more of a true word to say, it is a very nice smooth silent runner, as most of the noise is coming from the carriages and the wagons on both trains, if anything, as the Hornby Class 60 is also a very good model as well from Hornby. As you can barely hear the motor at all. The HST does have working cab lights, although the model is DCC ready. It does have an 8-pin connector. However, I'm not sure if there is a function where you can turn off the cab lights on DCC, but as you can see here, in analog mode, the Hornby Class 43 HST has the headlights and working cab lights on at all times in DC mode. But I'm not so sure about DCC, as I've never used a DCC fitted model of the Hornby Class 43 HST before. But just to give you an insight of what's to come in terms of upgrading this model, I do plan to fit a driver into the leading power unit, just like I did with my East Midlands Trains model that I used to own. I may add some passengers into the Mark 3s as well, of which will be most of them, as some of them I won't be able to access very easily. And the third thing I'm going to be doing to upgrade this model is I'm going to be adding DCC sound, which will be two of the MTU TTS sound decoders. But anyways, I do hope you are enjoying this video, and I hope you certainly enjoyed this review. I'm going to round this Hornby HST off with a perfect 10 out of 10 for the reasons I have previously mentioned during the video, as it is a fantastic model from Hornby, and I'd certainly recommend getting one of these if funds and space permits. Although, as this one is my first Hornby HST that I have, and it is the only one I have at the moment that is a premium model, and not including the two other models that I have, as one is the older Hornby model and the other one is a lemur, I do plan to get more of these models. And that will conclude my video. As always, thank you for watching.
I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback. Until next time, have a good week or weekend. Take care. Cheerio, all the best, and God bless. I will see you all in another video to come on this channel soon.